Hello friends, welcome to Abhishek tutorial. In this video, I will be covering Accounting Standard 16, that is borrowing cost. It is one of the most important accounting standard prescribed by ICAI and it is also relevant for examination purpose as this standard contains at least 4 to 6 mark question. जो भी व्यूअर्स इस वीडियो को हिंदी में देखना चाहते हैं हिंदी वीडियो का लिंक मैंने डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में डाल दिया है. सो विदाउट फर्दर ड्यू लेट्स जस्ट स्टार्ट. एज फार एज द एप्लीकेबिलिटी ऑफ दिस स्टैंडर्ड इज कंसर्न इट इज एप्लीकेबल टू ऑल द एंटरप्राइजेस एंड इट इज रिलेटेड टू ओनली एक्सटर्नल बॉरोइंग्स एंड दिस स्टैंडर्ड केम इन टू फोर्स फ्रॉम 1 अप्रैल 2000. नाउ वट इज बोरोइंग कॉस्ट. सो इन सिंपल वर्ड्स cost related to borrowing or in other words we can say cost incidental to borrowing is known as borrowing cost or in simple words we can basically say that borrowing cost is the cost which is incurred in relation to borrowing or associated with borrowings. Now let us take an example. Suppose if a person obtains a bank loan then he has to bear some interest cost and stamp duty cost and standard processing charges for obtaining loan from the bank. So these all costs shall form part of borrowing cost. Now the definition of borrowing cost as per accounting standard 16 is borrowing costs are interest and other costs incurred by an enterprise in connection with the borrowing of funds. Now, borrowing cost includes 5 type of cost like interest and commitment charges. As I explained above, that interest will be payable to bank in case some borrowing has been made by an individual. Amortization of any discounts and premium related to borrowings. Amortization of ancillary cost incurred in relation with arrangement of borrowings. Finance charges in respect of asset acquired under financial lease. We know that in financial lease, the lessor has to make a payment to, the lessee has to make an annual payment of lease rent to lessor. So that shall all form part of cost of borrowings. Exchange differences arising from foreign currency borrowings. To the extent that they are regarded as an adjustment to interest cost. So the exchange difference at the end of the year shall be regarded as the cost of borrowings. As we can see that in the example I have mentioned there. Now treatment of borrowing cost. So the whole AS 16 is dependent upon whether the borrowing has been made for qualifying asset or non-qualifying asset. So here in this slide I mentioned normal borrowing cost, that is the borrowing which is made for a non-qualifying asset. Then in this case we shall consider those borrowing costs as expense and it will be charged to profit and loss account. However, where borrowing costs are directly attributable to acquisition, construction or production of a qualifying asset, then it should be capitalized if it is probable that qualifying assets will give future benefits to enterprise and it can be measured reliably. So the nature of borrowing is need to be taken into consideration while making a treatment in this accounting standard. So suppose if the borrowing is made for the acquisition, construction or production of a qualifying asset, then the borrowing cost shall be capitalized, or if it is made for some other purposes, then it shall be considered as expense and it shall be charged to P&L account. Now, qualifying asset. The whole AS 16 is dependent on this definition as the nature of borrowing will be determined whether the asset falls within the purview of qualifying asset or not. So the qualifying asset is an asset that takes substantial period of time to get ready for its intended use or sale. Here, by the word intended use means it can be fixed asset. So it can be used for a fixed period of time, or sale means it can be current assets. Now, as far as the substantial period is concerned, ordinarily we shall consider 12 months of time as substantial period. However, a shorter or longer period can be justified on the basis of facts and circumstances of the case. Here are some examples of qualifying assets like investment properties, manufacturing plants and power generation facilities. And the assets that are ready for their intended use or sale when acquired shall not be considered as qualifying asset. So suppose I went into a car showroom and I want to purchase a car, then car is itself is a finished product, and there will be no time taken in order to construct or acquisition construction or production or acquisition of car, then that car shall not be treated as qualifying asset. Now, this is the important concept of this accounting standard, that is capitalization of borrowing cost. So, as I explained earlier, if the borrowing has been made for the purpose of acquisition, construction or production of a qualifying asset, then the borrowing cost shall be capitalized. Now, here are two types of borrowings: general borrowing and specific borrowing. So in general borrowing, the funds are borrowed generally and used for the purpose of obtaining a qualifying asset. Now, in this case, we shall first calculate the capitalization rate, which should be weighted average rate of borrowing cost, and thereafter capital cost will be calculated by multiplying the amount proportionate amount spent on qualifying asset out of general borrowing. Now, in case of specific borrowing, where funds are specifically borrowed for the purpose of obtaining a particular qualifying asset, the amount will be capitalized shall be a result of difference of account borrowing cost incurred during the period and any income on temporary investment of these borrowing funds. So we need to know when the commencement of capitalization begins. So if all the three conditions are satisfied, then the borrowing cost can be capitalized. Like expenditure incurred, there should be actual expenditure incurred. This AS does not work on the presumption or does not work on the notional cost. There should be actual expenditure incurred for the acquisition, construction or production of a qualifying asset, and actual borrowing has been made for the purpose of acquisition, construction or production. So as I said, that notional cost will not be allowed. Here the actual borrowings should be made in order to make it capitalized in the books of account. Activities that are necessary to prepare the asset for its intended use or sale are in process. So the activities should be in process, then the capitalization can be made for those borrowing costs. Now, suppose there is a temporary delay in the active necessary developments, then there will be a suspension of capitalization. However, if the temporary delay is necessary part of the process, then there will be no suspension of capitalization. Now, when does the capitalization end? Capitalization of these borrowing costs end? So the capitalization of borrowing costs ceases when substantially all the activities necessary to prepare the qualifying assets for its intended use or sale are completed. Okay. However, if an asset has been completed in parts and a completed part is capable of being used while the construction for the other part continues, then the capitalization for that completed part will cease. So suppose if a contractor obtains a contract for the construction of 100 buildings and till now he has completed 50 buildings and other 50 building construction is still remaining, then the capitalization for those 50 buildings which are constructed shall continue to cease. Okay. So there are certain disclosures which need to be made as per accounting standard 16, that is accounting policy adopted for the borrowing cost and the amount of borrowing cost capitalized during the period. So in my next video, I will be explaining you the significant differences between existing AS 16 and the newly incorporated Ind AS. So thank you so much guys. Please do like this video.